Get ready to match the stars. Jack Albertson, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Lynn Redgrave, Richard Dawson writes, and Patty Deutsch as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 75. And now here's the star of Match Game 75, Gene Rayburn.
Thank you, Johnny Olsen. I'm taking waving lessons from Lynn.
This is the royal wave. I thought you were doing it on your way in.
Now, does she really do it like that? Who started? The Queen Victoria?
Queen Elizabeth does it now.
She does. Like just like that? Is that the way they wave?
That's right, isn't it?
They have a mechanical hand.
You know what that
she's
means?
She's out bowling.
You know what this means in my family? Boy, are you going to get it when your father comes home.
Perhaps it means the same
thing.
Is that what you
same thing in the royal family.
Same thing everywhere. Yeah. Well, here's our champ, Rhonda Torgerson. How are you, Rhonda?
Excited.
Now, you've only got $100.
I know.
But you're happy to be in that seat, and you're going to have a chance at over $5,000. Are you ready for that?
Yes, I am.
Really? Yes. Have you written anything lately?
Few term papers for school, but that's
I see.
About it.
What year are you in?
I'm a sophomore, my second. My second year.
You're in your second year.
Uh-huh.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay, good luck to you.
We'll find out
how that turns out in 1 minute and 3 4/5 seconds. After this.
First Portrait Pointer. Make
teethwhitener.com. Order now.
Here we are. This is Rhonda Torgerson. She's going to try for over $5,000 now. Ready, Rhonda?
Yes.
Okay. Rhonda, we polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Sitting blank. Now, the answer that audience gave most often is worth $500 if you match it. If you match the next one, you get $250. If you match the bottom one, you get $100. Three of the ding-a-lings are permitted to assist. Whom do you call on?
Richard.
Sitting Bull.
Sitting Bull. Ah. You have one?
Brett.
Brett?
Oh, I'm torn between two.
What?
How about Sitting Pretty?
Sitting Pretty. That's two.
I'm Charles.
Charles.
I'm not torn between two. I'll take a rather crummy answer. Sitting Room.
Sitting Room.
Unless you're known Indian.
So you have Sitting Room, Sitting Bull, and Sitting Pretty. Now, do you want one of those, or have you got a better idea?
I'll go with Sitting Bull.
You'll go with Sitting Bull? I don't care if you go with Sitting Bull. I hear he's a terrific date. Yes. That's what we're looking for. And, of course, she hopes it's under the $500 response, but we got to begin down at the bottom and reveal the $100 response. Sitting Duck. That's a good answer now that I see it in print up there, isn't it? Did you think of that? You didn't think of that. There.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Sitting Bull. Are you under the $250 response?
Sitting
Pretty is. That's Brett's answer.
Sitting
All right.
Pretty.
Sitting Bull, we're giving you your last chance now. Please emerge from the $500 response.
Congratulations.
Okay. Now, Rhonda, that means you're up to $600. And that means you're going to play for $5,000. Remember, you got to match exactly just one celebrity. Time to choose one.
Richard.
Okay, Richard, you get ready to write. Rhonda will turn and face me, and here is the $5,000 question. Tidal blank. That's T-I-D-A-L blank. Now, he's finished. Rhonda, what do you say to that? How do you fill in that blank? Tidal blank in order to match him.
Wave.
Wave. The audience agrees with you, don't they?
Better than worms.
Well, it is better than worms, indeed.
No, it isn't.
Tidal wave for $5,000. She says, we'll match you. What do you say to that?
Where is Los Angeles?
Tidal basin.
Of course. Now, don't just stand there.
Wave.
To get married.
Congratulations, my dear. You now have a total of $5,600, and you're going to play another game. If you're ready for that, let's introduce Vicki Adler-Bloom. Where are you, Vicki? You can crawl up there as long as you... Vicki, you know Rhonda?
Yes.
How are you, Vicki?
Congratulations.
Isn't she excited and happy about that? And we're all happy for her.
Thrilled.
Now, Vicki, please tell us about yourself.
I'm from Yonkers, New York, temporarily. I'm living there with my husband. And I'm really from California.
So. Yes. Yes.
And like Patty, I'm on my way to becoming a housewife.
Oh, really?
Yes. And
you're telling us you're pregnant.
Yes.
Oh.
Yes.
Yes.
I was. Well, just,
no, she has a basketball
worry,
under her
catching.
Skirt.
It's not catching.
It's not catching.
When is your baby due?
August.
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 Okay.
And I've been married twice without benefit of divorce to the same man.
Oh. Well, whatever turns you on, Vicki.
Gene.
Jack,
now, what I always say is nothing like dealing with a well-established firm.
Right? That's right. That's what he always said. Vicki, we'll start this game and wish you the best of luck in a minute or so, but right now we've got this message we want to pass along.
Are you one of the millions of people living with...
Here we go. Now, Vicki, what do you say?
A, please.
A. Here we go. New game everybody plays.
All right.
Now, everybody in this room knows how terrific Jack Albertson is as the man on Cheap Over Now, right? We've all
seen
that.
How terrific is he?
I'll tell you how terrific. Oh. Well, the man said, I have to be nice to Chico from now on. Yesterday, he caught me under his car with a blank. That's what the man said. From now on, I have to be nice to Chico. Yesterday, he caught me under his car with a blank. You've seen Chico and the Man, haven't you, Vicki?
Oh, yes, love
it's
it.
It's a funny show, isn't it?
It's hilarious.
Now, you were there, so you shouldn't have any trouble with this at all, Jack. All right. Okay. We're waiting for...
Me?
We'll come over here to Vicki.
Along here. And...
The man said, I have to be nice to Chico from now on. Yesterday, he caught me under his car with a blank.
With a girl.
With a girl? She said Chico caught you under his car with a girl. What do you say to that?
Well, that's a long story and a dirty one, but I like that.
I don't want to hear it.
Okay. I said, wench.
Well, could we see your car?
May we have some... a wench. Oh, that's a girl. Isn't that interesting?
He's getting a little play on words, because wrenches, you see, and wenches, and
isn't that clever? We may let him stay for the whole week, huh? What do you say?
He's just as cute as Bugsy, isn't he?
Yes, he is, he is.
And he thinks he's a lot younger than he feels. I said girl.
Girl. That's two girls, Vicki.
Girl!
Well, look at that. That's very unusual for a first-round question for that many celebrity matches. What do you say?
Well, I thought that he was a little maturer than he lets on, and he'd have a woman.
A woman. Okay, that's four. Richard, are you going to break the spell?
Sure.
Oh.
I mean, what were you under there? With five women so far?
Oh, yes. Four.
A wench, a girl.
Well, including four, hers, four it's women. Five.
And this one makes six, senorita.
Senorita. So he has five girls and a señorita.
Yeah, and one little woman.
And one little woman. Yeah. Well, look at that. I tell you, nobody expected that, least of all her. You think it's August already? The way...
Cool. No, I hope
they're
not.
Just, they're fighting in there.
Yeah, they are. All right. Well, take a deep breath now. Rhonda, you're going to have two shots at this and see how you do. This is your first one. The princess said... Uh-huh. When I kissed the frog, I guess I didn't kiss him long enough. Sure, he turned into a prince, but he still has blank.
Oh.
Did everybody understand that, including Rhonda?
Yeah, I do.
You've heard about that story?
Yeah.
Good. Finished already? Well done,
Jack. Will you stop looking at what I'm doing?
No hostility in the upper tier.
All right, I've had it from you.
Hands under the table.
That's splendid. Just put it down.
Your hands are in.
We're waiting for you, Charles. All right, here we go. Now, Rhonda, the princess said when I kissed the frog, I guess I didn't kiss him long enough. Sure, he turned into a prince, but he still has...
Warts.
Warts. Good answer. Very good answer. What do you say?
Well, I said this. I started with freckles, but it turned out to be warts.
It did, yeah. Well, they grew. They have a way of doing that. Brett, what do you say?
I have a little wart right on my thumb.
Oh, you do?
So I said warts.
That's two. Thought we're going to have a repetition of that, it looks like.
I said webbed feet.
Webbed feet.
Webbed feet. That's right, tell him.
A frog doesn't have warts.
Yes. Leave him alone because he's been gone a long time and he's a little rusty. What did you say?
Yeah, well, I'm scared after that horrible reaction. I said webbed feet.
Leave her alone, too, because she hasn't got her second papers yet.
Oh,
Richard?
Trying to keep up a British smile, Al Walter.
Warts. So we got three. And Patty?
I never saw warts get so much applause.
Yeah. That's four. Yeah. All right, now we go to round two and push this button. And Vicky, since you've already matched every celebrity, there's nothing for you to do but just sit there and keep your fingers crossed. And you, Rhonda, will have your selection of A or B.
A, please.
A it is. Now you... Two people will play, Charles and Lynn.
The web feet people.
That's right. The two webbies are going to play. On New Year's Eve, Porky Pig was careless when he opened the champagne bottle. Uh-huh. Now, Porky has a cork where his blank used to be. That's on New Year's Eve. Porky Pig was careless when he opened the champagne bottle, and now Porky has a cork where his blank used to be. Did you hear that, Rhonda?
Uh-huh.
Okay,
yeah.
She's thinking about that while our celebrities are writing their answers there. Charles and Lynn. Okay, Lynn is ready. Charles is ready, and we call on Rhonda. When he opened the champagne bottle, he was a little careless, and now Porky has a cork where his blank used to be.
Nostril.
Nostril.
Pigs have pretty big nostrils, don't
right.
they? Yeah,
What? Boring. What did you say, Charles? Got to match both of them.
Is it Bagley near your home?
Bagley? Uh-huh.
I love that. That's why I put nose.
Nose and nostril, there's a match. Now, Rhonda, if you match Lynn, that means we have a tie game. We'll have to go to a tiebreaker. Let's see if it happens.
And I, because I know all about animals, said snout.
Snout? And we got a tie game. 6-6 a tie. Okay, you hurry right back for the tiebreaker after this message.
Today's consolation prizes are American Tourister Go Anywhere Lightweight Luggage, Continental Styling and Carrying Ease, American Tourister, the casual luggage that isn't made casually. And a two-test electric rotary lawnmower, effortless starting, and the OPEI safety approval seal exclusively from True Value Hardware Stores. You'll take the good times home with four cases of Heyer's Draft Style Root Beer. Quality and distinctive taste has made Heyer's a favorite for 100 years. Step right up. Get your blanks filled here when Match Game 75 continues in a minute.
Visit GotSuperBeats.com.
Now, this game ended a tie 6-6, so we say Shazam, and it goes out, and we push this button, and lo and behold, it's a tie-breaking question, one for each. The one who scores the most will be the winner. Vicky, which one do you want?
I'll try A again.
A again. Here we go. Everybody plays the tiebreaker. The ringmaster said, ladies and gentlemen, Stubnagel's Famous Circus proudly presents... Samson the Musical Strongman. He'll play your requests on a blank while he balances it on his head.
Good gravy, Marie.
Oh, that's sweet.
You know what I'm talking about.
now.
He'll play your requests on what?
Ladies and gentlemen, Stuppnagel's Famous Circus proudly presents Samson the Musical Strongman. He'll play your requests on a blank while he balances it on his head.
He'll play your requests on a blank
while he balances.
While he balances the blank, whatever that is.
Whatever the blank is.
Right, on his head.
He places it on his head and balances.
Exactly.
Oh, honey, that's easy.
Oh, so difficult working with these people.
What is it?
So difficult.
My shirt's ready?
Yes.
They're ready down here. Upper tier, the lower tier is
just
ready.
Wait a minute, dear. Are they ready?
Yes.
Dickie, are you ready?
Yes.
I said
they're all ready.
Is Miss Redgrave
all
ready?
Right. You now betcha. We got a Vicky Adler Bloom.
Betcha.
Even
hell.
The ringmaster said, ladies and gentlemen.
What?
What?
Why, you little mother.
Stuppnagel's Famous Circus proudly presents Samson the Musical Strongman. He'll play requests on a blank while he balances it on his head.
Piano.
Piano. Boy, was he strong.
He certainly was.
What do you say, Jack?
Well, I figured he had more guts, so I made it a violin.
A violin. All right, she's looking for a piano, Brett.
Do you realize he's gone rapidly downhill since Monday?
Yes.
For heaven's sakes, a little teeny-weeny piano.
Teeny-weeny piano. There's one next. Charles.
It was a strong man, so
yes,
why a teeny-weeny little piano?
Well, it's a
very, very large grand piano.
That's true, Vicky. Now, how about you, Lynn?
How about you, Gene?
How about it?
Nice to see you. Good.
Hello, how you been?
Right,
nice
good.
To see you again.
Good.
I haven't seen you since New York.
No.
He'll play your request on a blank while he balances it on his head. What say you to that, my dear?
I say, piano.
I love a piano.
Man, you.
Pardon?
You offered this little lady a piano?
Naturally, I would do that, yeah.
Would you put it on your head for her?
Certainly.
Okay. There it is, a piano on his head. All right, now would you help out a sister who is also toujours enceinte?
Or you've got that to.
With
yes.
Child.
Yes. That too, a reprise of piano.
Okay, that's five for you. Now you gotta go some, right? That was kind of hard. Rhonda, this is for you. Dumb Dora is so dumb. Hold on, I'll tell you. When she took a vacation to Turkey, she brought along a suitcase full of blank.
When she took a vacation...
Dumb Dora is so dumb, when she took a vacation to Turkey, she brought along a suitcase full of blank.
Is there some answer to that
there
that I'm not getting?
There is some really sensational answer to that.
Is there?
Oh, there is one fantastic answer to
that. Well, let's ask Ira and find out what it is.
It's not violin. No.
Took us to when I am going to
play a round here. I just write down in secret.
Oh, I got it.
Well, I'm going to write it so no one sees it here. I'll just go back.
Oh, I got it.
And it's just, did everybody read it? No. I'll just write down my answer here. You're finished, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm not finished.
Anyway, there is my answer. You may hold my answer.
And my pen.
Oh, and your pen. Yes.
Oh, I got it.
Just Brett, what are you doing? Come on now, Brett. Pay attention to this. Get into high gear.
I haven't been in high gear. Good gravy, Marie. I shudder to think.
All right, Rhonda. Dumb Dora is so dumb. When she took a vacation to Turkey, she brought along a suitcase full of...
feathers. Dad.
Okay. What do you say there?
That was the answer.
Well, I have an interesting answer to that.
Turkey hash. Turkey hash. Now you got to match all five remaining ones to stay in the game, Rhonda. Let's see if it happens, Brett.
You think that I am going to be the villainess, don't you?
No, I don't.
I said feathers.
Feathers. That's one for you, Rhonda. Did I capture the others?
I'm sorry, I said straw.
A straw. So that means Vicky wins the game. What direct do we have? Stuffing. Giblet stuffing. And my answer was stuffing also. Come on down, Vicky.
Congratulations.
Good. Okay. Now, Rhonda, you're going to leave being here with a bundle of money. Have you had a chance to think about what you're going to do with it?
No, I haven't, but I'm delighted. I've never had more fun.
Well, good luck in your educational career.
Oh,
it was
thank
a
you.
Pleasure meeting you, Rhonda Torgerson. And you've got $5,600. Goodbye. And you. Well, it's bigger than both of us. Now, here we go, Vicky. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Blank tricks. The answer they gave, remember, is worth $500, $250, and $100. Whom do you call on?
Richard.
Richard, what do you say?
A bag of tricks.
Bag of tricks.
Jack.
Jack.
Treat.
Treat or tricks?
Treat or tricks.
Treat or tricks. Let's see. His childhood is a long way away. He doesn't remember it was trick or treat, but what the heck. We'll forgive him for that. One more.
Brett.
And Brett.
Oh, how about... how about magic tricks?
Magic tricks, bag of tricks, tricker, and treat or tricks. What do you want?
I'll go along with Brett, magic tricks.
Magic tricks. All right, let's find out if it's up there, and if so, where. May we see the $100 response? Bag of tricks is the one that Richard gave you. Looking for magic tricks. Here we go with a $250 response. Dirty tricks. Oh, we all want to forget about those. Here's your last chance for magic tricks. $500 response. Magic!
Too short.
Rate today. Call 1-888-668-0066 or visit rate.com.
You're all just dandy. Yeah. Gene Raper, Match Game 75. Join us next time. Goodbye.
This is Johnny Olson speaking from Match Game 75, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.